and this little video is going to show you how to use some of the basic features in Gmail, just the usual things like how do you compose a new message, how do you reply and forward other messages, and so on. So let's dig into it. So here is my Gmail inbox, and you can see it's got a few messages sitting in here. And I might like to, first of all, compose a new message. So up here, I have a button that says compose. Now in Outlook, I think your button said new. Here it says compose. It does exactly the same thing. So let's click it, and this page will open up here and allow me to compose a new message. So I will compose one here to Mr. Van. So I'll start typing the word Mark, and you can see it populates with all the marks in the school. So I'll just press tab to lock him in. He was at the top of the list. The people who email most will actually rise to the top of the list over time. I'm just going to type here just a test, and hi, just testing. And so on. So that message is now addressed and is ready to go. If I wanted to attach a file to this message, there is a link here underneath here that says attach a file. If I click that, it just opens up a box and asks me which file I'd like to attach. Let's just say for the fun of it, I attach this one here and say open. And you'll see that that is actually uploading that file now into the message. And so bang, done. It's now ready to go and be attached. If I wanted another file, I could attach another file here just like that by clicking this. That message is now ready to go. I could now click the send button. In fact, let's just do that. So click and send. Okay, and off it goes. So that message has now been sent to Mark. Let's just show you another example. I'm going to click the compose button again. And this time I will send the message to... who can I send the message to? How about Mr. Burgess? Dr. Burgess. So I'll send this to Paul. And I'll put in here, hello, and just saying hi. Now, obviously, this is a message I'm probably not going to actually send to Paul. So if you ever compose a message and then change your mind about sending it, you can just click this discard button up here and it will throw the message away. The other thing that's useful to point out here is that it is actually saving this message regularly. It hasn't yet. But there's a button here that says save now. I can click that, or if I don't click it, it will just automatically save every couple of minutes. And it goes into my drafts folder. And you can see over here I have a folder called drafts. In fact, let's do that. Let's click on save now. Okay, and so that is now saved. If I don't send that, if I go back to my inbox and then click on drafts, you'll see there is the draft message. And it's telling me I have one draft message now that is the message I was working on to send to Paul. Just click on it to open it up again. And if I've now changed my mind, I no longer need to send this, I can click discard. So you have the ability to compose a message and send it, to save a message for later if you don't get finished typing the whole thing in one go. And of course you can discard a message if it's no longer needed. So that's about composing. What about forwarding and replying to messages? Let's just go back to the inbox by clicking on the word inbox. And so here is a message from Pauline. That is talking about she wants to get started on the Gmail, so that's great. I'd like to reply to Pauline. Now, there's an arrow in the top corner here. You might be fooled into thinking this is the arrow up here that is the reply. It is not. This arrow will take you back to the inbox. Let's just click it and show you. There you go. It takes me back to the inbox. So that's not what I want. The reply arrow is the one over here. It's actually showing right here. And I click that to reply. The other thing I can do is if I click the little drop down next to it, I have also the ability to forward the message. Now, if there are multiple people involved, I'll also see the option here to reply to all. But because Pauline and I are the only ones in this conversation, it is only giving me the option to reply or forward. So let's just reply. So I will click the word reply and just say, sounds great. Let's talk tomorrow. All right, and click the send button, and that message is now sent. Excellent. Let's just click this to go back to the inbox. You'll see that some of these messages have numbers next to them, and what that's talking about is the number of messages in a thread. So, for example, this one between Katrina and I, if I clicked on that, you can see that she's actually sent me a message. I've replied to her message, she's replied to my message, and so on. And so we have actually three exchanges in this thread of email. And what Gmail does is it groups them together, because think about it, it kind of makes sense that those replies would be grouped together. Here's another example. This one has 15 in the thread. Let's have a look at this. So I sent out a message the other day reminding people about presenting at this conference next year. And there are a number of messages in the middle, and here's the latest one, and here's my latest reply. If I click in the middle here, just to expand it, you can see here are all the messages that have been exchanged within this thread. Now that's great because it means I don't have to go hunting through my inbox to find all the replies that I got to a particular message. And it essentially groups anything together that has the same subject line. So it's a lovely way to gather all the messages together rather than have to go hunting for them. Threaded email, try it. You will like it. The other thing I was going to show you was forwarding. So let's just take this message here from Alison, and I might like to forward that on to someone else. So I click on the little drop down next to it and say forward. And of course, because it's forwarded, it needs to know who to forward to. So I'm just going to forward this to... Actually, you know what? I'm just going to forward this to myself at home so I don't bother everyone here with this demo. And I'm going to just say sample and say send. So there you go. So that now has been forwarded on as well. And that's forwarded on to someone outside of the school or my other email address. So there you go. So there is the ability there in Gmail to compose messages, to save drafts, to discard drafts, to also to forward and to reply to messages. So you can do everything you used to do in Outlook. All the features are there. Some of the buttons might be in slightly different places. Some of the wording might be slightly different, compose instead of new, but all the features are indeed there.